Hello, we're going to be looking now at a programming topic in OCR Paper 2. I'm going to be going through all the content you need for the exam. So even if you're fairly confident, please do just have a flick through of these videos just to make sure that it covers all the exam content, because you might have learned Python really well, but there might be bits and pieces which don't quite apply. For example, today constants don't even exist in Python. You still need to be aware of what they are. So variables, first of all, what is a variable? A really important concept in programming. My best definition is it's an identifier that represents a location in memory which holds a value that can be changed. Now, not exactly a definition which rolls off the tongue. I've tried chucking a few bits here. So first of all, the word identifier is a word you have to be familiar with. The identifier of a variable is its name. The identifier of a subprogram is its name. So an identifier is anything a programmer has decided to call something in code. Behind the scenes, as you know from paper one, all data currently open in a computer is being held in memory, in RAM most likely. So a variable is just pointing towards a location in RAM and it holds a value. That's singular, it's not values. Multiple values would be something like an array. So just to flag early on, identifiers have got certain rules. So essentially the main rules are it has to be one word. You cannot do two separate words as your name. And also we can't ever start with a number. So therefore make sure in any code you're writing, you are following these rules. Now another keyword is assignment as it relates to variables. So variable assignment is when we associate a value with an identifier. I think up a name, I then give it a value. That is what assignment is. So here is relatively simple code. If you have a look at it, we've got two variables being used here. We've got total and we've got num. We assign values using equal signs. So the equal sign doesn't mean the same thing as maths. It's not equality. It means total is now set to be zero. So you can see this third line, I'm going total equals total plus num. This demonstrates that the equal sign is not equality in programming, because clearly this is not an equal statement. A maths teacher would hate a statement like this. Really, what this statement is saying is set the new value of total to be the old value of total plus num. So in other words, the program does what's on the right-hand side first, and then it will save it as whatever is on the left-hand side. And we always need our identifier name on the left-hand side. You can't do something like 15 equals num. Now the bottom line is a print line. Print is how we show messages on screen to the user. It's one of our main ways of outputting data. Not the only way of outputting data. You could also output it to a text file, for example, but print shows what's on the screen. When I've got a comma, in a print line, the comma is replaced with a space. It's how you can combine variables with strings. When I run this code, we can see the value is 15. Total equals total plus num, set total to be 15, because 0 plus 15 is 15. And then in my print line, because total didn't have any quotation marks, it's treated as a variable. Therefore, the value associated with it is used instead of the word total. So that's where 15 comes from. It replaces total and the comma added a space. Okay, so the term you may be less familiar with is a constant, because constants don't exist in some languages like Python. A constant is like a variable, but it cannot change. That's our key difference. So pretty much the same definition, except that a constant holds a fixed value that cannot be changed. So here is some code which uses a constant. You can't do this in Python, but you can do this in ERL, which is why you have to be aware at least of ERL. So you can see base price is a typical variable, but tax rate is a constant. It's assigned in a very similar way. Tax rate is equal to 0.2. However, to set it as a constant, you've got to write the keyword const before your identifier. In this third line, I'm using print to output tax rate multiplied by base price. And you can use constants in exactly the same way as a variable. It's basically a variable which cannot change. So that's perfectly fine. I can multiply them together. I can do what I want. It's just like a variable. However, what I can't do is later on in my code, try and reassign a constant. A constant's value is fixed after it is first assigned. So if I try and change it to 0.4, I'll get an error in my programming language because I just cannot change a constant. Which begs the question why. We want to avoid errors typically. Why would I volunteer myself to do a constant? Why not just use a variable? A variable won't cause an error, so why would I kind of invite errors upon myself? Well, it's not so much about you. It's more about your colleagues who you can't necessarily trust always. So of course, Our programs so far are pretty much just us writing them. But if you're working for a big company, like a game developer or a major software company, you've got lots of colleagues who are also working on the same programs. And a big risk is where values start changing by mistake. Your colleague might not know that tax rate shouldn't change. They might try and use tax rate in a way which you don't expect them to. If I don't set it as a constant, they might change it by mistake without even realizing. This might cause some errors which are quite hard to fix. Another point related to big projects in particular is readability. So readability is about how easy the code is to understand. And adding constants does make it a little bit more readable. This is because if I see a constant, I'm going, oh, tax rate is 0.2. I can trust the tax rate is going to be 0.2 through the entirety of my program. I know it cannot change. So I can just kind of sub in 0.2 in my head whenever I see that identifier. However, if it's a variable, I don't know what value it is at any given point. I would have to track and try and watch what was changing if I wanted to find out what a variable value was. And a final point, which is really more for maybe even university to fully understand how this works, but if you use constants, it will slightly speed up compilation. Compilation is when a translator converts high-level language into machine code. We'll look at this later in paper two. But a compiler can do some clever stuff to optimize the process using constants, so it makes it a little bit faster. The final thing to talk about are inputs. So print is how we output messages to the user. Inputs are how we get messages from the user. And most programs at GCSE have to have inputs in some way. Don't forget to assign user inputs to either a variable or, less likely, a constant. So here is some code. I've got an input line in my first line. So I'm setting name to be equal to the input. I've put what's your name in brackets. This is called a prompt. This is the message the user sees. So if I run the code here, the user sees what's your name. They then are given a prompt to type in some input. So if I type in my name and press enter, Mr. Brown gets saved as the variable name. So name has been assigned the value Mr. Brown. This gets replaced with whatever the user typed in. And then in line two, I'm simply printing welcome followed by the contents of my variable, which was Mr. Brown. So this is how we should do it. And we have got to try and visualize that process. What they type in is being assigned to that variable. A common couple of mistakes I see in this topic is people, first of all, forgetting to assign it to a variable, them just putting input on a line and it won't go anywhere, right? If I type in something after this input, it doesn't get saved anywhere. To save it in memory, I have to assign it to a variable. But the other mistake here on line one is the prompt, the message in the brackets is not a message to the user. Especially new programmers often type in what they want to type in, like Mr. Brown would go in for brackets here. But the prompt is a message to the user. It's not what's going to get saved. What gets saved is what the user is going to type in. So that's not how we do it. You need to make sure you assign it properly and then write an actual message in the brackets.